versus the World pay-per-view this Saturday.
Dude, Team China's got some legit heroes. They've got Synergy coming in too with the Wraith King, with PA. They have scaling potential as well.
I think Sumail may have missed the mark a little bit here.
They gave him a stun.
Game stuns, lockdown,
an AoE teamfight ultimate from Void. Time dilation's pretty good in this game. And you look at Team World's heroes. If I had any of those heroes, oh no.
What are you talking about? I had that in my pub last night. This looks pretty similar to a 3K pub here over on the Team World side. Five cores, all melee, and really no home. I have no idea who's going to be the ward bitch in all this.
It
looks like Ice is pretty heavy in support. No, he's got four-man shield.
They've got Jarex jungling. We have it. It looks like it's going to be the Miracle roaming anti-mage, as Peter was talking about with the Orb of Venom. You actually are able to do a lot of catch. Faith Beyond's going to be playing, it looks like, a Slark with the Poor Man Shield.
Okay.
And oh, VCJ. VCJFY, they're actually smoked up. Team China, they're coming. Looks like they might be able to find somebody. Oh, and Miracle actually breaks it.
You want to get in there early with a First Blood and just kind of assert dominance in a match like this.
He gets stunned up by burning.
Do they have any more
stuns? Cold arrows. Are they able to chase him out? Nope, he's able to double down. He'll be just fine.
Again, only really one stun around. A pounce could help, but outside of that, you don't really have anything at level 1 to offer in stopping your opponent there. So
let's take a look at these. I'm looking at these items.
Keep a look at the items.
I think Burning's playing support, huh? Burning's got some boots on this Wraith King. Yeah.
So he's like that 4 roaming around for his team.
Does look like it. ROTK's got a Blightstone and Tangles. It looks like he might be the other support.
So they're not going to get like one really just worthless wards only kind of player here. If that's the case, we could see indeed all these freaking Midases come out and be in for a 2-hour experience. But again, shouts to the players for being able to participate in this All-Star matchup. A lot of them still competing and going into the later part of the night. All good. And looking to put on a bit of a show here.
I know Jarex is going to have a good time just straight up jungling, but Burning knows this. Burning's like, I'm going to go in your jungle and not let you do that. We have Miracle actually positioned himself. He's waiting for the courier. We do see, Miracle does want to go for a courier snipe. It's not coming out just yet, though.
It's not even moving. I don't even know if FY cares about the courier in this one.
Not just yet. So Team China does realize that it is a solo Terrorblade in the safe lane, so they're going to rotate the Phantom Assassin support up there and start pressuring him with the Void and PA.
Envy on the Terrorblade, of course.
Oh, bottom lane, though, Sumail. Oh, gets brought down. See? This is the problem. You pick a stun, and they even have a secondary kind of stun with the Pounce. So Pounce Leash with Wraith Fire Blast.
So Sumail's
very problematic.
Tilted now, right?
Jarex is already.
Just got to make sure he puts his teammate in check there. We'll let that one slide, but it's going to be the first nod going to Team China here. Mid lane, I'm seeing some sort of gank possibly break out here onto FY, trying to punish Lady Drow Ranger. It's Miracle, the roaming anti-mage, getting in with the slices. Now they're committing with the lance.
Oh, he puts a branch to try to block himself. Is he able to survive? He eats his fairy fire as well. Sitting at 40 HP. 10. And Miracle gets the finish up last hit.
Roaming anti-mage, look out for it in your pubs. New meta here.
You have to watch out. The amount of slow from Spirit Lance and from the Orb of Venom is just too much. Oh, Sumail again, bottom lane. He gets brought down again. Oh man, this is what happens. He doesn't have a stout shield in the offlane. This is unacceptable. Going
no stout
for
shield.
A Quelling Blade in the offlane? Sumail, come on.
No proper dual lane.
Universe would be very disappointed.
And I don't even know if he wanted to kind of forfeit the lane and go to the jungle. There's no more real estate space in there. Jarex is kind of already bringing through the mileage and probably sharing the jungle with that with Ice from time to time, but we'll see. Sumail just kind of adhere with it and head back south. But Jarex going to be the big breadwinner as he farms through that jungle front. It's going to be interesting. A lot of the heroes on the side of Team China are not going to be dealing with ruptures too well.
They will definitely suffer from that, yeah. Jarex is going to have an excellent game. We know we said it. Bloodseeker, he's just going to kind of be free up jungling, but it does seem like Team China is attempting to solve it. You know, they have ROTK roaming the jungle. They have Burning running around. Just constantly trying to keep pressure onto Jarex. They know that he's going to be the problem this game.
So question for you on the Drow Ranger. You're a Drow with a bunch of melee heroes. Do you actually even bother leveling up the aura, or do you skip it? Do you get a value point in it?
Value point. Probably 4-1-1.
Okay.
Depends on how his lane's going. I think it's going to be depending on that one. He should have it just fine time versus the
DL. Emperor is here.
Oh, they're in. The double roam.
Oh,
the crit by Burning.
They need another one.
Jarex with his misclick. Oh, 18 HP.
He's got him.
They don't have the mana on Burning. Just out of range of the dagger. The boots, will they be enough? They are. And the crit to finish him off.
The chop down from B-God himself. It should be a privilege, really.
Is this burning, involved in all three kills, 100% kill participation from B-God himself.
And I guess Sumail's done with bottom lane and is going to be the new roamer suddenly.
Oh, Burning's taunting him a little bit. Just kind of walking around. He's got the TP up if he wants to. Oh, yeah.
I'll just TP on
your Sumail drops his items. He's like, come on, stop that TP.
Very cute.
So taking a look at the CS right now, it does seem like Team China is dominating. Not only the kill department, but lanes across board.
Mid lane, top lane, bottom lane, all getting a serious
FY though,
farm.
Getting pressured pretty heavily by Ice. Accidentally walking up on the hill there. And it looks like he's just going to go for not really getting the gust, just a couple more levels in the precision aura. Just for himself. Just very greedy play.
Curious about how these skill buildups are going to be quite different, considering the circumstances that these teams have been put into.
So far,
ridiculous.
Checking out a couple of these heroes, we do see a couple of items being put into quick buys, just the boots. Nothing crazy just yet.
I'm curious to see for the cores who are now delegated to the support position, how they itemize from there.
Ooh!
Looks like SCCC, still taking it to Envy here in the top lane. He's got 24 and 8, Envy on the other side, 16 and 5.
Burning's got boots, wind lays, clarity's already. Oh, Fit Beyond's getting some pressure on him bottom from the Miracle rotation, but now we do Burning with the Rape Fire Blast. They're turning it onto Sumail and Miracle.
Nice,
but do I say that? Fit Beyond actually getting turned on, dropping very low.
Oh, they're gonna go
40
for
HP. Miracle. Is he gonna get done? Miracle gets done. Fit Beyond cleans him up. Sumail gets the last hit, but he's gonna go down himself here by Burning. Again, Burning everywhere. Involved in 5 kills already. He has his Wraith King. Unbelievable.
Greatest player on the planet. The raid is going right here. It's going to get out of control fast. Sumail takes another fall on this one.
Oh, look at Miracle. Oh, man, what a mistake there. He tries to TP to fill Ice's bottle. Oh, Sumail does it right, though. Miracle messing up, but Sumail not going to mess that one
up. These guys are not used to having to do that, where they have to send to a lane. They're used to being the guys receiving the filled bottle, not handing it off.
I believe he actually... Oh, RTK breaks the smoke instantly, but now he might get turned on. Miracle with the body blocks. Orb of Venom. The shrine is not ready. ROTK, he's getting right clicked down. The dispersion, or the desolate damage plus the Orb of Venom from Miracle just too much.
Hey,
now Burning, being chased out a little bit. The Orb of Venom. Oh, no way to stop that TP.
They need stuns to cancel TPs.
Anti-Mage not 6 yet. The only stun that they actually do have on their lineup.
So TPs of high value here for Team China, I imagine.
Yes, absolutely.
Already high value when you're going against a Bloodseeker.
Oh, mid lane though. Now again, Miracle just with these quick rotations everywhere. FY getting body blocked up again. Oh, and he gets brought down quickly.
Nice
Miracle
take.
And Burning, definitely the standout player so far for this match.
Good stuff there. ROTK gets to take over the mid lane for now.
Sumail just tanking a bajillion hits from Fit Beyond, and oh my god, what is he doing?
He's dead, that's what he's doing.
He just let himself get 10 stacks of Essence Shift already. It's 6 minutes in the game, how is that even possible?
He's tilted.
Oh, Sumail, come on. Miracle, Burning, standing toe-to-toe. It's trade-off. Miracle baiting with the blink. He's got it up at the gust from the low ground from FY. Are
Ooh.
They going to clean him up? No, they're not. It looks like Miracle's got a blink.
He's out of there.
Very close. Mid lane. Ice. Fit Beyond even making a rotation in. Ice. Trying to make a little tricky player there with Illusion, but no. They know better.
They do. And they got his number. He goes down. China up ahead. 7-4. I think I know the game plan overall for Team America here. They have, or Team World, rather, they have put Envy in the top lane on this Terrorblade. I don't think he's going to venture away from this. He's here.
Yeah.
He's going to Metamorph Towers, and he's going to nerd sweat the hell out of this top lane.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be, it's pretty much going to be Envy and Jerax, just the big playmakers in this game. They're going to be, the weight is really on their shoulders. We do see Jerax putting the Midas into his quick buy, so he's jungling just fine, almost level 6. We do have Void already, level 6. We do see the rotation coming top. They're going to be a Chrono onto Envy. Burning, going to lead with the Fairy Fire Blast. Will they have enough damage here to bring him down? He does not have Sunder. Skilled, he doesn't have a skill point saved either. Is it enough damage? The Chrono coming out. It looks like Envy's going to be brought down by this one. Are they going to turn out to Miracle? He has the blink away. He should be just fine.
Easy enough for SCC to get it done. I mean, when you have to factor in the fact that you're probably going to be the only one doing damage within the Chrono, you have to make sure you can get the job done. So, fair enough there.
Later on, they will have the Drow Ranger to be able to put some damage into that Chrono.
Of course. But for now, though, Tryhard Envy in the top lane is going to be put on the sidelines until he can make his immediate return. So, the big factor I'm seeing in this game already is just the roaming Burning.
Yeah, and I mean, Faith Beyond has a Midas as well, so his safe lane is heavily secured from that rotation coming out from Burning. Mid lane, Ice, committing with the Doppel onto FY. There's some rotations coming out. He's trying to be cheeky again with that illusion, but it seems like they know something is up. The jig is up, Ice. It looks like they've isolated him. He's going to be brought down here.
And I like the play.
He gets FY before he dies. Big mistake there by FY, giving up way too much dice with that committed try rotation. Looks like Jerax making his first move. He's got Rupture online. SCCC uses the Time Walk aggressively. He's Ruptured. No TP on him either. Looks like he's going to get brought down here easily by Envy, Miracle, and Jerax. I say easily though, but Liquid almost. Oh, I say Liquid. I mean Miracle almost get brought down.
I like how Jerix came by just to make sure he could watch it happen. And
yeah.
Walks away back to his farm.
Just throws the rupture and he's just like, all right, let me just get some experience. So Jerix almost finishing up that Midas. We check out the fight recap.
What the hell are you doing, Miracle? Just trying to draw Burning back into what could have been an awkward spot.
Uh huh.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's a fairly even game, though.
Really?
Yep.
It's funny, because you look at the net worth, it's already Slark way out of the top. Yeah, overall team net worth is down the middle. Faithfion has been secretly doing work in that bottom
lane. Look at this
lane,
teamwork. Jerix and Miracle just doing the Ancients together. It's only 8 minutes in, and they're able to do that? That's very impressive.
It's going to be a lot of potential there,
mid lane,
of course.
Mid lane, RSK.
Should be
brought down. They got vision of him from the Thirst, and they're able to get the Lance on him. Excellent play there.
The Blood Rage is also going to have some nice little things going on for Team Wolf, too.
Uh-huh.
Blood Rage Lances.
The Blood Rite's going to be pretty big in this one, Faithfion.
Oh, yeah.
His big rotation coming in. He misses the pounce, though.
Uh-oh.
He's ruptured the Blood Rite on top. No, he doesn't get the Blood Rite off, though, but Faithfion still ruptured. Ice, trying to put some pressure onto FY here. Here we go. The Blood Rite comes out.
They turn around and they will take him down. That's the highest net worth for Team China going to get dropped at that point. So.
Great haunt there by Sumail as well, just trying to get involved into the game nice and early.
Yeah, it was a tough early game for him.
And now
so.
Sumail, though, might get turned on, burning with the stun. ROTK with the dagger. Are they able to pressure him? ROTK, though, dropping very low. Yeah, she gets bought down. The Blood Rage.
China crumbling.
Oh my goodness. The Blood Rage with the Spirit Lance actually is way too much damage. I did not expect it, as well as Miracle with the Mana Void. Oh man, this might be the first tower of the game coming out here, but do
Big
I say that?
Huge Chrono! Drow Ranger! Dishing in the damage! She got like four arrows off in that Chrono, and it's doing so much work!
Oh my god, unbelievable Chrono by SCCC. Just, you can't, see that's what the problem with giving a team just massive team fight potential like that. It's, you gotta be careful when you're sieging those tier ones without Eternal Envy there.
He's got that Midas building up. I hope he goes for the refresher. Double Chrono could certainly do this team a lot of work.
I hope to God we don't make it there.
Let's get a replay on how monstrous this Chrono was. Look at
Miracle sees it though. Miracle's like, not gonna get me, but FY, he actually gets 1, 2, 3, 4, almost 5 arrows off during that Chrono sphere. That's a lot of damage.
It's a lot of optimal damage right there. Shouts to Miracle being able to kind of get the wherewithal to get the quick juke back.
So we mentioned a couple of the Midases, but now we're starting to click on a, you know, just taking a look at a couple other heroes. It looks like almost everybody has a Midas into their quick buy here now. So FY does, SCCC has one finished up. Ice, not going to be going for that. He's looking to go pressure. He's going for drum on the PL.
Shouts to RTK, he's the only guy with a ward currently in the
inventory. The rupture coming out again. SCCC, he's going to TP to base. Are they going to have the burst from? Oh, the Mana Void coming in for Miracle to cancel it.
Oh, Faithfion now looking to get in the action, has to pounce away here.
Oh, great rotation here by Envy. I love this. Blood Rage, Terrorblade beating on the tower.
Oh, that is gonna hurt.
That is
Blood
the big
Rage,
thing.
Blood Rage, Metamorph, Terrorblade.
No, they have a good amount of tower siege. The Drow lineup, they don't really have anything else that benefits from precision, so it's just really the Drow who's going to be able to siege. This makes a lot of space for Sumail here in the offlane now, too. Going for that Midas, too. RTK
like
also has one in his, as has a Midas in his quick buy, so like I said, Midas is across the board.
Faithfion returns back to the lane here. Sumil can't do much on his own. Good, Burning was nearby waiting it about. And then PA here, top lane might be in a little bit of trouble.
Team World though doing a great job. They're already almost pulling ahead by 1,500 gold. That's pretty dominant in the first 12 minutes, I'd say. Especially when we were kind of favoring Team China's lineup just a bit.
Yeah, but you know, World is getting some good passive farming happening right now. They're building up a serious economy behind all their heavy core heroes. Though VGJ, they've already shown they got a little bit of synergy to work with, and they're going to use it while they can, whenever possible. When this Chrono's up,
big smoke coming out.
Now,
the Chrono's up. Sumail looks like he's going to be in trouble. Are they going to use it? Are they going to commit it? It looks like they're gonna.
They got Faith outside of the bubble, and of course FY as well. And
the response TPs though. Miracle coming in. Jerix as well. FY attempting to TP out. They get the silence on Miracle. He's not able to cancel the TP out. SCCC looks like he's going to survive well, but Faithfion might be the culprit here of this dive. A nice pounce into the trees. He doesn't quite have enough quite mana for the TP. Looks like he's going to be chased and brought down by Miracle and the crew.
He has nowhere else to go and no more blue bar to work with.
SCCC also still being chased out by Ice. Still too many time walks. Burning now. In a little bit of trouble, but he does have the reincarnation. Will they be able to proc it? Sumail really wants to. He really wants to.
Just do it, Sumail. Put him down.
Sumail.
Oh, no. The Gate Guardian has showed up in SCCC, and they're looking to turn it around. They will get the Life of Burning. But at what cost? Costs us his life. It's going to cost Ice too.
Oh, man. The very greedy play. Diving between the tier 2. Oh, it was way too early for that. Come on, guys.
14 to 12, 26 kills in 13 minutes. I wish this was every game at this tournament, but...
I believe that dive actually may have just, like, evened out the game, too. That was a little bit of a mistake there coming out from Team World.
All right. Now it's going to get exciting, Fog, because we have talents starting to come into play here. Mm-hmm. I'm curious if anyone is going to favor something a bit different, or if they're going to all play this, like, as if they're all position 1s and position 2s.
I believe anything that helps you farm is probably going to be the choice. It looks like Miracle. He's got Phase Boots, he's got Urn, Orb of Venom, he's gonna go for the Manta next. Just heavy fighting. He's getting pounced on here. Faithbeyond almost able to bring him down, but lots of stick charges on Miracle. He'll be just fine. Mid lane, Jarex, another Rupture. Are they able to bring down Ice before he TP's out?
Oh my goodness.
Are they able to bring down FY before he TP's out? Ice with the rotation, he does survive, though.
The TP's are such high value right now for Team China, but it's starting to feel like the damage is coming in for the World's team, and that means that these TP's are not gonna be as effective, so.
Man, Jarex is pretty huge, though. He's almost got his Shadow Blade finished up. And he's buying the wards, it does seem.
I am the farmer here.
Top lane, again, Sumail getting the pressure on him, ROTK and burning. Oh, they bring him down quickly. Or do they? Yeah, they do.
He couldn't even move. Orb of Venom, they Fire Blast.
Well, burning in some trouble of his own. Beautiful TP canceled by Miracle.
Out for good.
Now they're going to be able to chase it down and get two kills here.
Get his brother in arms and ROTK. Nice little jump to the lane, but he's surrounded. Done for.
And now they're going to be able to pressure the tower. Envy's up here too. Envy's got his Midas. He's got meta up.
Oh, give him the sweet blood juice and let him take that thing down.
S-triple-C and FY though, hitting the mid tower while Faithbeyond hits the bottom tower and cleans it up. So good trade there coming out from Team China.
Now, what do you think? Based on the two lineup, I don't think it was touched on a whole lot in the panel, but who's better at taking towers, pushing the objective? You got a little bit of love on both sides. You draw on one side, you got the Metamorph Terrorblade on the other.
I think just a little bit of love on both sides. I'd say probably the Metamorphosis Terrorblade, just because you don't really need any too many items to complement that, because they do have the Blood Rage. It naturally gives you just high burst and damage. While Drow, you need your levels, you need like maybe one item. But they do already have the Dragon Lance up on FY here on Drow Ranger.
Okay.
So we do see some nice items coming out already.
You're going against all melee. Keep your distance further with that. ROTK is just eating so much damage. It's a Metamorph, for God's sakes. SCC won't be able to make it away, but...
They're gonna go for two towers here. Team China doesn't have any D-push. None of their heroes really are able to counteract this anyway. They have to make heavy rotations. Burning coming in, Reincarnation though on cooldown. Looks like Faithbeyond going for a solo kill onto Jarex though, with FY coming in.
Nice little snipe there in the mid lane, but you're losing towers here, Team China. The top lane now completely ransacked. And that's a big boost of money going on across the board here for the World team.
A lot of map control as well.
Yep.
Gives them some slight Roche potential if they do feel like going for it. They don't really have the lifesteal like Team China does, but we'll see. Lots of wards coming out.
Yeah, look at the wards.
From Team World all over the top side of the map.
Got good coverage all over the area. They just kind of ran right through. Mm-hmm. Being able to keep tabs on Team China while they probably look to put Worlds work on the other half of the map. We have to see. When's our next smoke play going to come out? Are these guys going to manage to coordinate a smoke move?
It does look like Burning just uses his. They've got Chrono online. They want to be able to claim some tier 1s. The last tier 1 top.
Now, they are running their way through wards, obviously not being detected, but I'm sure the World's team is seeing that a lot of them are missing off the map right now. We'll have to see how privy they are going to be onto this. Or is it straight
to Roche? Oh, the scan comes out. They actually got them. Oh, they're going for the Roche. This might be expected here. They've got Spectre ult.
They're doing it.
Well, they know. The Lifesteal, the Drow Aura.
Pressure on Faithbeyond. It does not look like World team have any idea this is happening.
Oh, this is so smart.
Who do you give it to, though? You're burning, so he gets yet another extra life. Do you think S-triple-C is the highest value farmer? FY, maybe?
S-triple-C or FY, probably, but... Yep, S-triple-C does seem to grab it up. He looks like he's the heavy farmer with the Vlads, the Midas. He looks like he's going for an S-N-Y build onto the Void. Bottom lane, he sees the pressure coming out.
Oh, FY might be done for here. They are going to catch him off. Ice shows up, hits him with a lance.
Whew, good thing he didn't have the Aegis there.
He will be taken down just as fast as they're able to get the Roche. Real unfortunate there for Team China as the pressure just continues. World team moving through the bottom lane next. They're going to be claiming a tier 1.
So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 Midases almost completed now on the board.
7 Midases. The greed! Yeah, no different than any other game we saw today. So, here comes Whirl. Are they going to keep pressuring this bottom lane? Because look at this push. That's 3 range creeps, a catapult. That's a tier 2 for sure if They don't have a response.
Oh yeah, the Vlad's pick up from SCCC. RLTK also was building up that creep wave for quite a while up there.
Now, the problem, as I believe Peter pointed out on the panel, was that these teams do kind of lack the capability on either high ground defense or being able to siege into the high ground here. So do you think that at a moment here, let's say if the world team is able to kind of take it all the way to the China side, are they going to be able to defend the high ground well?
China, I think, has a little bit more trouble defending the high ground than Team World does. Team World at least has the Spectral Dagger to spam out the creep wave. They have the Blood Rite as well, and maybe the PL spam. It looks like PL is going for Aghanim's, so he's going to be able to push the waves out a little bit harder in that manner. So, if anything, I would actually be giving the favor to Team World here into the later stages of the game if it does get to that point.
Okay, so while
Team breaking high ground.
Yeah.
Oh! Miracle, nice TP cancel coming in. FY gets
a
good gust.
BM cancel.
Nice. Being in.
How dare you cancel
my TK with a big crit onto Miracle FY. Looks like he might be into trouble, but the rotation coming in for Burning. Ice is just trying to be so cute with his illusions, and it might work. They might be able to pick up the kill onto FY. The Haunt coming through. Big Chrono into Mail, though, on the outside. Gets the dagger finish. He's going to pay with his life, but that's just all right. ROTK, ruptured up, in some trouble. He gets brought down by the rupture.
Very nice grab there.
Ice continuing the pressure, though, with Jerax. Well, he's just playing with them with these illusions.
Let's see. Finds the real Ice, tries to jump onto him, and it looks like he might have second-guessed it, thinking it was an illusion, but Ice does make it away, being very crafty with the PL.
Massive amounts of space being created for Team World here. Envy just like, I can farm this whole time. He's almost got Manta-style finished up on this Terror Blade, pressuring lanes, farming to his heart's desire.
Looks like any other MP Envy game to me.
Yep, and bottom lane, Jerax moving in on SCCC. They've got the Blood right on him. They've got the dagger slow. Are they going to be able to chase beyond the tower? They don't have anything to stop. The TP isn't enough damage. It is. There is the Aegis, though. Burning, rotating in.
Shows up. And that he's a man alone. So they just turn on to Burning and say, how dare you even think about coming by and helping out? They'll just take him out, too. Dominating already for Ice on what is considered a terrible hero.
This is starting to become slightly problematic. Just hemorrhaging a few too many kills on the Team China now. It looks like it's Team World Tem to push this tier 2. They've got meta online. Envy has his Manta style too, leading the net worth at 10,500.
You can just tell by the body language here from Team China, they want nothing about it. They have headed up north, and they're not going to worry about this pressure until maybe it's too late, until maybe their tier 3s are getting hit. So they better just leave it as it is, because they are not winning the farming game right now, and they've been losing in some of these exchanges.
Tier 2 cleaned up. Jerax with the last hit, Shadowblade finish, Midas as well, as we mentioned before, looking like he's getting toward that level 15 point, so we'll see what talent he chooses to go for.
Ooh, baby on.
Sumail.
Spotted
in some
Sumail.
Trouble. Oh, he's juking through the trees. Oh, he's even gonna hit. Oh, Envy with the bro play, giving Sumail the Sunder.
Okay. Nice little bro play right there. Hands off a high five and some life. And
Beyond's in some trouble now.
Trapped on the low ground, can't
the
make it away.
The boy to finish him off.
It popped like a balloon.
Nice little juke play coming out from Sumail in the tree line. Fifion going for a very risky play there.
Here comes Team World, 20-18, but holding the net worth advantage. Burning, trying to farm his way up. Jerax, though, feels like he has a rupture every freaking second here. He's pump faking it. Gets it off right now as help is rotating in the form of Miracle, that roaming anti-mage. Working out pretty nicely. Burning trying to toggle his way through it, but will eventually go down losing his first life as they pop up. Miracle steps away. And look at this, Sumail showed up, has caught SCCC trying to get in on the action, but it's still a 3-on-1 going for Burning. Meanwhile, Envy taking towers, SC gets the kill onto Sumail, they'll finally bring down Burning.
They had to come in a lot though for that Burning kill.
They did.
Top lane, they're going for the tower.
What is happening? They're inside the high ground, they're about to take a tier 3!
They're going for the racks, these people have TPs!
They're using the full momentum
they have
of
no
this
TPs.
Draw lineup.
Only PL has a TP. Oh, anti-mage as well. Picks one up from the side shop. Okay. But the Rax is already claimed.
Oh,
massive play from Team China there.
Oh my god. Are they going to get away with this? Are you going to let them get away with this?
Wow.
They let them get away with that. They come into
so
the home.
So much space coming out from Burning. That bottom lane just took them so long to kill him. Wow.
Oh my goodness. ROTK dancing around with Miracle as he misses like every right click here.
He should be brought down.
Okay.
Though.
He only had level 2 blur. Still fires, finally finishes him off, but look at that. The first Rax going to be sieged. The Drow lineup deceptively moving across that top lane under the nose of Team World.
Yeah, we take a look at the net worth, and it's actually still pretty much dead even, though. This is a very close game. Still anybody's to take.
Burning.
A great play, though, taking that Rax.
Yeah, the space creator Burning in the bottom lane. And something that I'm sure Team World are going to try to keep tabs on now. They drew out the map that they are going to try to have Ice probably move through that top lane to keep things a bit equal. But Newbie now should have opportunities to maybe push some new fights.
Man,
need more time for the Chrono though.
Ice is constantly, even when there's no one even hitting him, he is doppling and sending his like his fake illusion backwards, making them think that it's him. Look, he does it again. Every single time he's doing it, he's just playing mind games with them. Or he's just being Daryl and being a troll, which is highly possible. But it has worked in a few situations while they were putting pressure on him.
I like that. Do it every time and you'll just never know he does it.
Look, he did it again. He just keeps, if you can just, you don't even have to like glance at it, but just look at the mini map. You're going to see a PL running away from the main PL every like 8 seconds.
Yerix with the Shadow Blade creeping in. FY's nearby, but
I know something's up. Faith Beyond pings it out.
You can quite see where he is. FY's waiting. He's got the long con. But this lane's going to get cut pretty far forward here. Faith Beyond waiting out on the other side, but rotations are coming in from the rest of Team China.
Oh, I love this pickup here by Envy. Going for a Solar Crest. They are all physical damage on the side of Team China, so some early evasion and some early armor. Definitely going to be really, really potent.
Well, World will step back. The pressure's still there in the top lane. It looks like they're going to make a full shift all the way up there too. DD, Rune. Now picked up for Sumail.
FY in some trouble here.
Uses the ult to commit in with the help of that DD. FY gets a nice little gush back, but he is still a man all on his own. Can he find a spot to TP out from if he buys one? He doesn't even have one. Still wiggles his way through those trees, but eventually it will catch up with him. And he does get dropped.
Jerax coming in with a rotation as well.
Nearby.
The Chrono coming in. He grabs Faith Beyond in it though too.
Oh no! Is he able to get the burst power to finish off Miracle? He will take that one at least, but he's quickly surrounded by some other world fighters. But no, they get another takedown in Sumail.
Oh, Ice is in trouble now too. Oh my god, the bash is coming out from S3C. Faith Beyond as well with that rotation. Just
oh, but who's pushing
play into
whose base now? Suddenly Envy shows up into the mid lane and gets some sieging power down onto the tier 3, but burning quick to respond. Helps deal with it, but he's a Wraith King hitting one creep and one illusion at a time. Not the easiest.
S3C is starting to catch up to Envy in the net worth. He's going for Maelstrom. He's got the Yasha finished up. Looks like he's going to be going for a Silver Edge of his own.
Safe lane or one position farming Faceless Void isn't the craziest thing in the world. We've seen VTJ even do it not long ago in the hands of Aggressive, so probably a bit of a comfort pick almost. I mean, comfort might be a bit of a stretch, but something
but we'll give
not,
it to him anyway.
Yeah, not something that's too far-fetched for them to kind of be able to build up all this farm on.
Synergizes very well with the Wraith King and the Drow Ranger. The Chronosphere is just looking to be... Every single time the Chrono is up, it does seem to be that Team China just awakens themselves quite a bit.
Unfortunate that SC did get Faith Beyond in it. We didn't see the start. Maybe Faith Beyond walked into it. Whatever the case may be, allowed them to get the one takedown, the second takedown, and then, of course, the RNG working wonderfully in their favor.
Mm-hmm. So we do see Anti-Mage finishes up his Mantis style, so he's hitting a little bit of a power peak here for himself.
That is that roaming support Anti-Mage, right? Suddenly
uh-huh.
Now with the Mantis style. Okay.
He's doing great for himself.
How are they all finding little bits of farm? I guess the Midas is just the magic touch. Outside
oh, yeah.
of that, there's not much available here. Newbie going for their second Roche.
Pretty important to point out too, S3C, I believe he's the first level 20 in the game. Just gonna confirm that for myself. Yeah, he
looks like it.
He is the first level 20 in the game, and he does get his 120 GPM talent, so that's gonna be massive for himself in the later days of the game. Jerax getting gone on here by Faith Beyond. Will he be able to get brought down? S3C there. Oh yeah, he's dead. That's
easily
a lot of gold.
Handled. Easily handled there. Uh-oh.
It's starting to look scary for Team World. They're just getting caught off guard. They're not grouping up. They don't really know. They can't really break high ground too well. All the tier 2s are claimed. It's just that Team World, they're suffering now at this point. They don't really know how to group up properly versus this Team China lineup.
All right, we got a bit of a congregation here in the mid lane coming up from Team China. Tier 2
They've
goes down.
They've got Aegis. It looks like this just might be the second set of racks. Or second racks could be going down pretty soon. Will they be able to defend it? Do they have the eggs on the PL? He's still quite a ways away. He's not able to de-push them too
hard.
Chrono coming out.
On what they thought was maybe a real target, but it was not. I guess that was just a Daryl illusion.
The mind
games. Maybe a mirror for Manta? It's hard to say, but it was already committed out now. It's going to be the Han dishing on right now. Going to get the blast finish off on S3C. They are going to be losing Miracle as the follow-up, but a commitment down the mid lane.
Team China's
to be
in
able
trouble
to get
here.
The finish. It's Sumail on the run for this one, but Burning has pressure on his back in Envy and Ice dishing out Metamorph damage in the Wealth of Illusions. It's going to force Team China to try to step off. But Burning returns, tries to blink up, goes for the TP, makes it away. three for two trade at the end of this.
Whiffing that chrono, just unacceptable by us, Triple C. It's pretty much their big lively point is every time he's gone for it. He's had some great ones this game, but that one just...
Big swing there.
Oh, yeah.
And some new life to breathe here. Team World, maybe on the back end of his Metamorph, is going to use it to pressure back this mid lane as much as possible.
Yep, we do see some Aghanims being picked up now. Jarex has that double charge for the Rupture. We have Ice with his Aghanims as well to be able to push out the lanes.
Some nice Aghanims pickups there. Ridiculous amount of illusions now, and there's not really any way China's lineup can deal with that or use it to their advantage, you know?
Yeah, we do have SCCC, he built a Maelstrom, so at least he has that to be able to deal with the Phantom Lancer illusions. Quite good at it.
That would help. Maelstrom would help. I mean, I don't know. I don't think RTK is going to get a Battle Fury or anything. Maybe just more Maelstroms across the team, if anything.
Yeah, more than likely.
All right, Miracle. Box out SC. Let's slide there for now. For this ward game right now, I'm seeing a crap ton of wards down the mid lane. You know, a lot of core players, they found the ideal ward spots for the Vision. It looks like they found mid lane pretty appealing to keep an eye on.
Oh, definitely. I think these wards were placed, I think a little bit before the Rosh, I want to say. So it looks like they were probably trying to defend themselves from that one as well as just get some nice vision around the area. We do have Sumail finishing up his Yules on Spectre.
The classic pickup.
Yeah, just the standard pickup for Spectre. Support, offlane, whatever
move
you want to
speed,
call it.
More daggers
TP
to spam.
Cancel is the most important thing.
Yeah, no way to cancel TPs. This gives him an extra answer for sure.
It gives him a couple more setups too. Even though he's not the Bloodseeker, you can set up Bloodrites pretty easily with Yule Scepter. It's quite good.
Yeah. I like that. But VGJ, what do they got going here? Smoke play.
Now, VGJ, Team China.
Yeah, Team China. They are not afraid to come together and make smoke plays happen.
Oh, Envy is going to be the target. The stun coming out. He four-steps himself with his high Hurricane Pike, but it looks like he might be able to get brought down. He's got the Sunder ready, though.
Oh,
he gets gusted, though.
He can't get it off in time. He gets dropped. Isaac shows up, but it's going to be too late to assist. Can they manage to creep in at least one kill of burning? They'll get the Reincarnation forced out. Oh, Sumail tries to jump in, has to jump back and jump back again, trying to avoid the onslaught of damage coming his way, but
the
they finally get
him
with the chrono! They'd be stuck on the inside once again, but BG tried to make the most
is a
out
miracle.
Of it. They get it done. SCCC with his Faceless Void putting in the work.
Oh, Jarex tried his best. He got the double rupture off, but now that's all he's got.
Pulling the wave back.
Yep, he's just trying to get them away from that
so
Rex.
So fast.
But it looks like he might be able to do it.
He's dancing with him.
He's got the Shadow Blade ready. Oh, this is bad, though. Team World's only got Jarex alive. Is he able to keep the wave off of the mid lane Rex? I don't know if he's going to be able to. It looks like they're just going for it anyway. They don't even care about backdoor.
Okay, can they manage to muscle their way through it? It's looking pretty good, actually.
Envy comes out.
You're not going to have to buy back at 20 seconds left. Stalking him now, but this looks like a tier 3 to go down, and they're going to be hitting the Rex.
Oh my god.
They lose the Rex!
Team
oh my
World.
God!
Just too many mistakes, just being split up too often. Beautiful chronos coming out from SCCC, just too much for them to handle.
They're the team that has the one team fight.
Oh, Jarex gets spotted by Burning, trying to TP out. He's going to get chased away, Burning!
Giving the crowd what they want to see. Forcing someone to bow before Mighty Emperor Burning here in his Wraith King.
Oh my goodness. Don't look at the net worth. Just don't do it. He looked at it.
We took a peek, and it wasn't good what we saw. Now, Maelstroms and shooting for the late game here, I guess, if your Team World.
It's just been Team China for the past 6 minutes. Every single time, it's been the Shrines killed, Towers killed, just beautiful setups. Oh, and Miracle almost gets brought down.
That was close. Makes it back inside, though.
It's looking really troublesome.
I mean, if you're Team China here, you're not letting up the pressure, I imagine. You're just going to keep taking it to Team World outside their base.
Yeah.
Because if they're cramped inside one little part of the map, you have to somehow share that farm with all these ridiculous heroes.
Sumail on the chase. He's got a gem as well. SCCC doesn't even care, though. He just turns Chronos and mans up the Sunder from Envy, though. The Solar Crest as well. Is it enough to save Sumail? It is.
What a bro.
Are they going to be able to trace SCCC? Doesn't have a TP on him.
Surround him.
It looks like they should have enough, yep. Wow, Envy with the team plays.
Okay.
What a guy. The XD coming out from SCCC and the Xoxoxox from Sumail.
The extra emphasis of that Xoxoxox makes me feel a little bit of a breath of salt there, but World's still fighting back here. Hey, come on now. Let's keep it simple here, Team China.
Damn.
Feeling themselves right now.
He's mad at Envy. I mean, that was a pretty big play there coming up from Envy with the Sunder and Solar Crest.
I could see that all chat there sparking a mini fire under some of the asses of Team the World. I want to see them take a kill and then talk back now. That's what I really want to see.
Here we go. There, you might actually see it. ROTK getting chased up.
Sumail moving there and get a kill. And let's even this game back up a bit. No, Sumail, here's trouble. Has to go for the UAC to get the bring down. And he's hiding within the trees. They're going to turn it back on the pit beyond, and they'll get the finish. Double kill for Envy. Team World take a first promising swing.
They grouped up. They started to recognize what their problem was. Every single time they were getting split up, they were just getting caught by these Chronos. Now, when they know that SCCC is dead, it's their time to shine.
Lots of gold, specifically for Envy on that one, too. As he charges his way down. Been the bro, too. I thought he was going to be very try-hard in this one, trying to take over a lane and just move his way through it. But he's been there for some of the skirmishes. He's been there as an assistant, as a support. And he's their top farmer at the moment, so here they go. Let's give that point maybe a...
They've got meta ready.
Blood power.
SCCC, though,
up the damage
is in position. Sumail gets the Yules on him, though. He's got the gem for the vision. SCCC gets rooted up. He's in the blood red. He still gets hit by it. Rupture onto Burning. The glyph comes out. They're still beating on the tower, though. Tons of illusions. This looks like it should just be a nice frag for Team World. SCCC almost gets brought down instantly. Gets a decent chrono. Oh, is he going to get brought down? He is. Oh my god. This could be Team World bringing it back. SCCC does not have buyback.
They turn it back onto Burning and wipe him out. Miracle walked into that chrono and also almost lost his own life, but managed to step away. And now Team World can go back to their eyes on the prize.
Oh my god, this is insane. Envy.
This game is even back up. Envy with the back end of his Metamorph trying to do as much power as he can. Can they get another Tier 3 before they have to bail? Do they have to bail?
The turnaround from Team World right now.
This crowd is really quiet at the moment. Here we go.
Envy. Here they go. They're trying to, but Faithbeyond almost gets brought down. Envy, pretty strong here. Burning, overcommitting a little bit, gets brought down by all the illusions.
ROTK was pushing towards that backline, trying to get wholesome mail. Now he's way overextended outside the comfort of his home. And Ice hits him up with a defusal. Now they'll be able to get a bit of help. Stepping in, FY and Faithbeyond trying to assist. Turnaround, slam down of Sumail. And ROTK trying to swing at Envy here. Can he get the crits? Can he get the love? No, he can't.
Oh my god.
Miracle.
Hits ice, ice, ice.
The, and they take him down, and they're going to get the finish on the Rax.
The Diffusal Blade with the Aghanims. There's just too many illusions coming out from the PL as well as the Terror Blade. Oh, the sun, aggressive Sunder coming out for Envy. Atos attempted to go onto Faithbeyond. He's able to get the Dark Pact off, though. Sumail with the chase. Miracle as well. Are they going to clean him up? Yules, he is Shadow Bladed up. Not going to be able to clean him up. FY now able to clean up Miracle, but the Tier 3. It's in trouble. It looks like they're trying to claim the Mega Crypt with the illusions.
Are they really going to get the Megas right here and now? Oh my god. Team China, you got to do something. You got to do something to stop this. You're about to lose it. They are going to get the Ghost Blast onto Envy. They focus fire him, and it looks like they'll finally be able to shrug him outside the base. But look who's inside, trying to get as much as possible. It's Ice. Claims another Rax here. The third melee. One more building stands before the Megas are going to get unleashed.
See, now you can look at the net worth graph and we can have lots of fun. But first, we do see another Rupture coming out from Jarex. Just to put some pressure onto SCCC.
Just keeping him in base.
He's getting scouted though here. Faithbeyond looking for the chase down. Jarex, he doesn't have Shadow Blade up. He's got the Blood right now, but he should be able to get cleaned up here. Or is he? FY with the cutoff.
Hi, how you doing? Blast him with the Gus. A few arrows, and that should do it. Can he juke within the trees here? Jarex.
He's dusted up though.
He's fast. He's
fast. Really fast.
He's out of there. See ya later, nerds.
Another dust coming out, but he should just be so fine. 600 movement speed for him.
For a guy who limps, he sure moves quick.
Oh yeah, boots of travel with the phase, so he gets that bonus movement speed as well as the slot being quite low.
And we suddenly have more of an even game. Actually, you know, more so for Team World, given the damage they were able to do inside the base, but can they get it back to the other side again? Because just as fast as they were able to pressure the base, suddenly almost all lanes are pressured onto the Team World side again.
It's all about the chrono. That's really what it is. Jared, SCCC, trying to get positioned, but oh my god, they're going for the Tier 4.
Going for the jugular. Is that what you do? They force out the buyback, and Miracle moves in.
SCCC's they don't have chrono for this fight. This could be devastating for Team China, but they do bring down Miracle very quickly here.
Good targeting there for Miracle to take the chrono out of the fight on this one. Burning also going to be forced to step back. Can they burn through his mana before he can
get back? They've got to get out of there.
China can't make it back. A buyback was forced out from SC on this one, but the fight may be already over. ROTK, Blink Strike over, trying to get a hold of Jarex, but can't get it done. Team China move themselves inside the compounds of Team World and end up losing more casualties than they went in with.
my goodness.
More buybacks here.
And Atos onto Pythion, chasing him out. Miracle, Sumail. They're going to be able to bring him down here. This gem is doing so much work on Sumail right now, purchased by Jerax, though. And now it's time. It's time for Team World to go. They've got meta. He only has it for a couple more seconds. They have the waves pushing in, though. Forcing a buyback from Faith Beyond.
They're pinging on him. They want Envy.
As Triple C has Chrono.
Oh, missed him. But they'll settle for Jerax. Just gets annihilated there. Oh,
Jesus.
No!
Miracle! But Miracle's in! Is he gonna be able to clean the range tracks? 500 HP. He's burning
this
a fake illusion away.
Wants to go to bed. He doesn't want to hang around for an all-star game. He wants to end it here and now. Trying to backdoor for the Megas.
There's more illusions coming in. Are they gonna be able to claim it?
Can they hold it?
80 yeah. HP. Envy's just gonna keep throwing illusions at it.
That is
Team
dirty.
China. Team China's gonna watch it.
That is how the world team
here it
world
comes.
Are gonna do
the illusion.
It.
ROTK. China chases it out. Envy, is he gonna be able to get it with this illusion? It's going for it, but it gets stunned up by burning. Illusions do reduced damage to buildings now, but only 80 HP left on this last range racks. Unhealable damage.
Unhealable. Oh my. It's a dirty way to win, but it's a win. Let's see.
S-Triple-C, I mean, all the weight is on his shoulders for those Chronos. Envy with the illusion, he's gonna claim the Megas. All Team World needs to do is just defend.
Oh,
the line is drawn.
Team China could land an epic Chrono somehow.
This could be it. ROTK draws the line.
Close it.
They're ready for this. This is the last hurrah from Team China. Are they able to do this versus Team World? Jerax gonna be respawning soon. Miracle does not have buyback.
The pride.
They're
the
going
dignity.
In. Tier 4. Burning blinks in.
Everything on the line here for Team China to stay alive in this game. They're going to get the tier 4 down. Burning should fall shortly after, though.
The mana burn is too much.
As C moves in, can't quite find the shot. He gets hit, he's going to lose his mana. If he does not get off a Chrono in good time, tries to time walk back, but it may have been done already. Frantic pinks are coming out from Team China, but they can't even deal with Envy.
The game's over. Team World looks like they've claimed this. Team China just too desperate.
Envy
God is back.
And they get it done! Team World wins! You wouldn't know by too much excitement, but there is a round of applause. Dota has been appreciated on this day. It was a lot of fun. Team World with the 5 Melee core lineup. Get it done. Unfortunately for Team China, it looked like they had the better draft on paper. You had a bits of synergy there between your Chronosphere and your Drow Ranger, and they even took the first set of racks. But fucked. Team World win it on this day.
Oh yeah. SCCC just unable to get that Chrono off.